गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रीड क्लास 7th SST पार्ट हिस्ट्री चैप्टर नंबर 5 आर्किटेक्चर पेंटिंग एंड म्यूजिक। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी हैव टू लर्न अबाउट द म्यूजिकल डेवलपमेंट और द म्यूजिक डेवलपमेंट व्हिच वाज प्रिवेल्ड ड्यूरिंग द पीरियड द मेडिवल पीरियड दैट वी हैव टू सी इन दिस टॉपिक। सो बेसिकली एज यू नो वेरी वेल द म्यूजिक इज़ वेरी old entertainment means that people entertain from the music. So the music which was divided into two sect, that is the North Indian style, that is the Hindustani style, and the South Indian style, that is the Carnatic style. So this two division that prevails in the medieval period as well as today in the present day also, the North Indian music is considered as Hindustani music and the South Indian music is the classical music is the Carnatic music. So how the Hindustani music has emerged during the period of Mughal Empire, that we have to basically see in this video. Now they can see the Hindustani music is the mixture of the tradition of Indian music as well as Persian performance. So how does the music get mixed with the Persian? It is just like that we have studied in the architectural development as well as the painting development. So it's the when the changes occurs, the changes is visible in every aspects of life and thus every aspects of society. So that changes the Persian mixture is also visible in the music as well. So the music has become very important during the reign of the later Mughals, basically the Akbar, and because he hired a lot of singers in his court. One of them you have heard the name of Tansen. Due to advent of Islamic rulers, Northern India caused a considerable cultural interchange. Islamic rulers started taking interest in local forms music, which gave the chance to musician to become the part of the royal court. As I said, Akbar had took a very keen interest in the music, and that is why after taking interest, that is why the music, the basically the Hindustani classic music had started emerging with the Persian performance. So why it happens? It is because the ruler or the emperor who were there during that period, they took keen interest in music. So because of that, they took interest and they hired, like they had hired the different architect for painting, they hired the painters. Likewise, for the music, they've hired the musicians. As all Islamic rulers were outsider, the initial rulers were fond of their own type of music. So it is very distinct that the rulers, those who came from outside, the initial ruler, the starting ruler, whether the sultan, whether the other rulers, they like their own tradition of music style, or they like their own music style basically. But the latest rulers have started emerging the different Hindu culture, and they started emerging or mixing the Persian or the Islamic cultural or Islamic cult music. So because of that, this gives the fusion to the Hindu and Muslim ideas that bring a new musical synthesis, that is the Qawwali and the Khayal. So Qawwali and Khayal is a new form of music basically that emerged just because of Hindu and Muslim ideas. So this gives a new musical or the music, the way of music to the Hindustani musical style. Abul Hasan Yamin Uddin Khusro, or probably we call him Amir Khusro, you might have heard from different sources that Amir Khusro was a Sufi singer and he was a poet and a scholar from India. So he was a great Sufi singer. Sufi cult is like we in the Hindu religion, we can see the saints, the different saints or the bhakti saints, you can say. Likewise, in the Islam religion, Sufi saints are there. They used to live a life, a pure life, as well as the life which is not depend upon the lavish life or the luxurious life. So, like Amir Khusro was also, he was a Sufi, and he was Sufi saint basically. So he is Sufi singer. He was also poet and a scholar. Scholar means that a person who had the studies on different subject, who studies the different subject basically. Also, he was an iconic figure in the history of Indian subcontinent. He was a mystique in the Dine Ilahi. I had explained that mystique is a who had the supernatural power basically, and a spiritual disciple of Nizamuddin Aulia. So his guru, his teacher was Nizamuddin Aulia, and he had a different spiritual powers basically he had. So though he was a disciple of Nizamuddin Aulia, you have heard about the Nizamuddin Aulia Dargah that is situated in Delhi. So he was his guru, he was his teacher in he shows the path of Sufi to the Amir Khusro. He wrote poetry primarily in Persian but also in Hindavi. So basically in the beginning Amir Khusro, whatever the poem he wrote in Persian language, but he started Hindavi, that is a mixture of Persian and Hindi language, and he was also considered as a father of Urdu literature. Khusro is regarded as the father of Qawwali as well. So Qawwali, you might have heard from the different sources, the Qawwali is a devotional form of singing of Sufi in the Indian subcontinent. So he introduced the Qawwali style of singing. Also, he introduced the Ghazal style of singing into India, both of which still exist widely in India and Pakistan. So you know very well, the Ghazal and Qawwali, these two form of singing, is still prevail in India as well as in Pakistan, because the Pakistan was the part during that time. Khusro was an expert in many style of Persian poetry. So though he was a scholar, though he was a poet, so he had expertise in the different style of Persian poetry. Khayal is a Hindustani form of vocal music adopted from medieval Persian music and based on Drupad. So Drupad is a classical Indian music style, Hindustani style music, and a Persian music that is mixture and mix up, and that gives the birth to the Khayal. The Khayal is a thought or imagination in Hindu or Hindi or Urdu basically. It is unusual, is based on improvising and expressing emotion. So khayal is what? It is just based on our thought and imagination. So khayal is, it is a presentation of our imagination towards our God and as well as for the good deeds. Khusro is credited with the fusing Persian, Arabic, Turkic and Indian for the singing tradition. So Indian language especially, he concluded the Braj Bhasha in the 13th century. Khusro is credited for the invention of the sitar and tabla. It is said that the sitar and tabla was invented by the Khusro, what we are using as a musical instrument currently. At the time, there were many versions of Veena in India. He re-christened the three-stringed Tri-Tantri Veena or the sitar. So this is the particularly this Veena what he had created. It is of three string, and that is why it is known as sitar, or the three string instrument, or that instrument probably get the name of sitar. Amir Khusro was a prolific classical poet associated with the royal courts more than a 7 rulers of Delhi Sultanate. So Amir Khusro did not serve only one ruler or two rulers, he served 7 rulers of the Delhi Sultanate. He wrote many playful riddles, song and legends which have become part of popular culture in the South Asia. So what he wrote रिडल्स, रिडल्स इज अ क्वेश्चन बेस्ड सॉन्ग, वी कैन से इट इज अ क्वेश्चन बेस्ड सॉन्ग रिडल्स, और पहेली वी कैन से सॉन्ग एंड अदर लीजेंड्स लाइक ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द रूलर्स, द इन द प्रेज ऑफ द रूलर्स. ही रोट अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स इन द डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस बिकॉज ही हैड अ कमांड ऑन द डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस. अमीर खुसरो ऑल्सो क्रेडिटेड विद सिंथेसाइजिंग मैनी एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ हिंदुस्तानी म्यूजिक एंड ऑल्सो इंट्रोड्यूसिंग द सेवरल रागाज लाइक यमन कल्याण, जीलफ एंड सरपदा. सो दो ही हैड अ नॉलेज ऑफ डिफरेंट म्यूजिकल म्यूजिक वेदर द हिंदुस्तानी म्यूजिक और द पर्शियन म्यूजिक वॉट ही ब्रॉट फ्रॉम देयर, ही ऑलरेडी इन्वेंटेड अ लॉट ऑफ ही गिव्स न्यू फॉर्म ऑफ डिफरेंट म्यूजिक. ही ऑल्सो गिव अ डिफरेंट राग लाइक यमन कल्याण, जीलफ एंड द सरपदा. सो दिस इज बेसिकली इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द अमीर खुसरो एंड ही वॉज कंसीडर्ड एज अ ग्रेट म्यूजिशियन ड्यूरिंग द रीन ऑफ सल्तनेट एंड ही कंसीडर्ड एज अ ग्रेट पर्सन ड्यूरिंग ड्यूरिंग द डिफरेंट दिल्ली सुल्तान्स बेसिकली एंड दैट इज़ वाई हिज नेम इज़ मैंशन for the development of the musical instrument as well as the music music compositions as well. A Sangeet Ratnakar, it is a book that is means ocean of music and dance. It is an important musicological test from the India and it is composed by Sarang Dev in 13th century basically, and it had the both style of classical music in that, whether the Hindustani music or the Carnatic music. So this books gives us a good impression, it's provide us the knowledge about that this book is written into the this books is written in Sanskrit and this book is provide the Hindustani information regarding the Hindustani music as well as the Carnatic music during the reign of Alauddin Khilji. The orthodox Islam is frowned upon music, but after the acceptance of Sufi doctrine by Islam, many Muslim rulers and noblemen showed their patronage to music. So at the beginning, the Islam always, or the orthodox Islam's Islamic people, they did not like the music. But when the Sufi cult or Sufi group is started emerging during that time, so they started accepting the music in the Islamic culture. So after acceptance of the different Islamic leaders, so the music become the integral part of the Islamic culture. So that is why, because of the Sufi cult or Sufi saints, they had started adopting the music in the Islamic culture. So this gives a chance to the Islamic rulers to encourage the music into their reign. The Mughal rulers like Akbar and Jahangir, Shahjahan, they known for the acceptance of music, and from the other zones like Iran, Afghanistan, Kashmir, they all these areas, the musician from these areas, they started coming towards the together to the Mughal emperor like Akbar, Jahangir and Shahjahan, and they started accepting the music and started mixing the music form from the Indian style to the style what they had brought from the Iran, Afghanistan and the other regions. So it is happened in the Akbar, Jahangir and Shahjahan region, because these three rulers were known for their religious tolerance, and because of that only they had accepted the music, painting and the other thing. Some famous musicians such as Swami Haridas, Tansen, Baju Babra, they had left the impression of the history of Northern India as a performer and the innovators. So you know very well that Tansen is there in the court of the Akbar. Baju Bawra was also there, the court magician of the Akbar, but there is not much information regarding the Baju Bawra. But you have heard a lot of about the Tansen, and Tansen was a disciple of Swami Haridas. There you can see the picture of Swami Haridas. Swami Haridas was, he did not went to the court, royal court, but though he was a part of the Mughal Empire, Mughal Emperor Akbar, and his disciple Tansen was there, and he served as a royal magician or the court magician to the Akbar. So they considered as a performer what they had learned, and they had also innovated a different musical and the musical style, as well as the they had innovated different musical instrument as well. Swami Haridas, he was a spiritual poet, and it is said that he was incarnated. He took the incarnation of the music god, and he was considered as a classical musician, credited with the large body of devotional composition. He done a lot of devotional composition related to the god in the Drupad style. He was also founder of Haridasi school of mysticism, where the different form of musical and as well as spiritual form of education is giving in that particular school. His work influenced both the classical music and the bhakti movement of the North India. So what he had composed during his time, though that music or that composition were sung during in the classical music as well, now we are singing, and during that time bhakti movement raised, the bhakti movement topic you will read in the further chapters of your class. But the musical style that was started during that time, it is get helped by the Swami Haridas, though that he was considered as an incarnation of the god of music basically. So he sang a lot of things about Radha Krishna and their true love, and he made a different composition on the basis of the Lord Radha and Krishna. Tansen, he also known as Ram Tanu, and he was a prominent figure of Hindustani classical music. You have heard a lot of about the Tansen, and Tansen was a composer, musician and vocalist. He sings, compose different song, and also he was a musician. He used to know the several instrument to play. Also Tansen, his composition is attributed to the northern region of Indian subcontinent. He had done a lot of development in the musical industry, or the music, we can say in the music he had done a lot of development. He was also he was also instrumentalist who popularized and improved the musical instruments. So as I said, not only he composes music, he also played a very lot of instrument, and he improved the old musical instrument that gives the more sound effects. He is among the most influential personality in the North Indian tradition of Indian classical music called Hindustani. So it is said that for the Hindustani music, he had done a lot of different things. He had took a lot of initiative for the improvement of the Hindustani style of music. The Baju Bawra, as I said, there is no such more information about the Baju Bawra. He was the musician at the court of Raja Man Singh Tomar of Gwalior, and he was there for the 15th to 16th century. He lived during that period into the Mughal period. So these were the some of the famous musician, those who were living in the Mughal court, and they were, the Tansen was one of the nine ratnas of the Akbar. So these instrumentalist and the vocalist and composer, what they had given to the music and the musical society, that is a part nowadays also. Many musical forms like Qawwali Khayals and different ragas, Yaman Kallan, and many more things that was invented, or that was emerged during the 13th or 12th century, during 13th century, that is also become the part of the present day. And what the instrument they had made and what the improvement they have done in the different instrument, musical instrument, that is also prevails in the current day. So this gives Indian music to a good platform, whether it is a Carnatic music or it is the Hindustani form of music. So basically we have to also understand the Muslim rulers who came to India, what kind of impact is there on the music of coming of the Muslim or the Islamic rulers. So what impact basically is there on the music? So let us see, it was categorized into two effects. That the first effect is they de-emphasized the word of classical song. First, what they had done, because the composition which was made by the Indian musician or Hindu musician, those were in the Sanskrit language. So what they did, they de-emphasized the word of the classical song, and they had only because the Sanskrit language is only understandable or the incomprehensible by only the Hindu scholars, because Sanskrit is only that is the person who have those who have the knowledge of Sanskrit, only they can understand the classical music. So they de-emphasized, they did not promote the Sanskrit language. So Sanskrit was replaced by the different dialects. So Sanskrit was replaced by different dialects such as Bhojpuri, Dakini, and Urdu and the Persian language. So the dialects is what, it's a sub-language or the upbhasha, we can say. So like Hindi's upbhasha is Bhojpuri and Dakini. So different musical composition which were in the Sanskrit, they get changed, they get replaced by the Bhojpuri or Dakini, as well as Urdu and Persian language, what the Islamic ruler brought from there. Though the Urdu language is understood by the Hindi speaking or also and Persian speaking person also. So that is why many compositions were made into the Urdu language. Songs were based on Hindu mythology. So many Muslim musicians sang these songs with the Hindu religious themes. So during that time, as I said, the impact of Hindu and Islamic culture on both the Hindus, mythological songs were sang by the Islamic or the Muslim musician, as well as Hindu musician also sang the song that is dedicated to the Muslim saints. So this gives a good impression of the influence or the fusion of the Hindu culture and the Islamic culture. So this was the good impact that is seen on the musical style of the Indian music, basically, whether the Islamic style of musical style or the Hindustani style of musical style. There is one ruler, that is, his name was Ibrahim Adil Shah II. You have already read about him in the previous chapter of Mughals. So he was the ruler of Deccan during that time, and he wrote one book, Kitabul Navaras, that is the book of nine ras, right? Nine ras, that is a music in the Dakini. Also, it is a collection of 59 poems and 17 couplets. So 59 poems and 17 couplets are there in the book. According to his court poet Muhammad Zuhri, he wrote it and introduced the Persian theory of the nine ras. So different nine ras you will read in your upcoming classes, the different ras are there. The way of expression, basically. So there are nine expressions. On that base, he had wrote a different musical poems and the couplets. So this book, Kitab-e-Navras, it shows the Indian beauty to whom? Those who know the Persian. Because and the person who knows the Hindi as well, because in that book, the opening of that book or the Kitab-e-Navras had the first page, and in the first page there is a prayer of goddess Saraswati and she was, as you know, that goddess Saraswati is, she is a goddess of learning. In praise of her, one prayer is written on the first page of the Kitab-e-Navaras. So this shows that the religious tolerance during that time means they had also accepted the Hindu culture as well as the Islamic culture. So he wrote this into his book. Also, he wrote this praise of Hindu deities and the Muslim saints. This is a very common thing that if he wrote in the Persian language, but it was started with the Hindu devotees or Hindu goddess, that is the Saraswati. So definitely this shows that he was a religious tolerance ruler during his time. Let us see the second impact on the music during the Islamic ruler. The second impact was the royal patronage of the Indian music was noticeable when there were any competition between the musician. So you have already heard or you have watched so many movies, there you can see different musical competitions were there into the musician court, whether it is the Mughal rulers, whether they are the Deccan rulers or the South Indian rulers. So they had different musical competition, and the competition emphasizes only the skills and technique of the musician, what he used. So what kind of technique, what kind of skills he or she is using for the performance, whether the dance or the music, that is become the more important during that time. Sometime they gave great importance on the creative imagination of performing musician. So during that time the performer had infused his own style he innovate his own style into that music. So this makes the people or the audience to change their judging skill from what he is performing to how he is performing. So earlier it was what he is performing, that is good, but when he started innovation into the music, so it gives the chance to the judge, to the audience, that how he is performing, what initiative, what innovative step he took for the music. Also, traditional themes were remain the basic Indian music, but it is the performer who interpreted and imagined everything by their skill and rendered the main substance of the modern Indian music. So traditional themes were remain what it is in Hindustani style of music, what it is in Carnatic style of music, that theme is remain, but the innovation, the new imagination of the different musician, that gives the new position to the music in our musical industry or musical culture. So this becomes the part of current day or the present day situation or the present day musical industries as well. So this is the topic, this is the chapter that we have to discuss in the this chapter, and this chapter is over. Or what you have to do in this video, that you have to collect the information of Tansen, the person who was the Navaratna during the reign of Akbar, and you have to write about the Akbar in your copy. That's all, student. Thank you.